So I noticed that the passenger footwell was damp with quite a bit of water. Anyway, so all this guide was soaked in water. You may not notice from above because my carpet was really completely dry, but when I lifted, there's all this kind of foam. It's really wet. I checked the driver's side, so that's I'm right now on the right side of the car. It's American model. I checked on the driver's side, left side of the car was very dry, no issues. So it's only on the right side, and I noticed there may this side it's the blower, cabin blower maybe. I noticed there might be some water traces coming from above. So I went outside. Let's have a look. I need to remove this plastic from underneath the wiper arms without removing the wiper arms, just plastic. It has four retaining pins in the middle. This is one of them on the side. You need to depress the center, and most probably you will drop the that small pin and lost it. So you may just want to put some zip tie or something like that to replace those pins. There's four of them. You may want to remove maybe three on the side here, and just there's two small pins on the corner, and this gives you access. Just put the lamp in there. There is a cover here. That's the blower entrance. This cover, it has four clips. One of each side, careful with it because it's plastic, it's fragile. At the bottom, if you notice, this is a drain here. Goes under the almost behind the engine, goes down below. It's really a drain, and it has four holes, two in the front, two in the bottom. Just touch them. I'm sure you can see it. Yeah, I can see it here. Make sure those holes are empty of leaves and debris. Sure, if you could see it, there's a there's like a foamy here, and mine was okay all around except here towards the front of the car. I'll show you with a small mirror. If you can see, you notice the foam was like crushed at that very exact place. Just there. Wow. So make sure the holes here are empty of any debris. And I believe the issue is that the water goes like there will be water from the rain going in there, but the blower catches all this water and it has a drain, which normally you may want to check if that drain is clear. It's a tube inside. And it's draining all the water properly. But if the water goes like this on the side of this and leaks past the wall and past that foam that's crushed in there, it may get into the car, into the footwell. So maybe you just want to make sure that this space and that foam is well in place, maybe replace it or put something to seal it properly. Just cut and inserted a piece, couple of pieces of foam. See, this is the place where the foam was crushed. And now, hopefully, so I just want to be sealed both at the top and at the bottom of of the foam. So both at the top, because the water can leak from the top, right? And also at the bottom. So both here and here. I want to be sealed. Hopefully this will fix the issue. Look for the water on the footwell. This is the right side of the car in the front. There's another connector here, so it goes just under the glove box. I'm not sure if you need probably to remove the plastic. There's a plastic there with the light. So there's electrical connector coming in the car, and you notice this is wet here, and this is just a rubber. So the water is coming through the rubber by the rubber here. And it's really easy to leak inside the car. I'm not sure if mine was doing it, but there's another point to check. Maybe seal it better here. Lastly,
probably not lastly, but another one. You may want to look to the just grab the light properly. So this is the bottom where you get to insert to the cabin air filter. There's four screws, but the bottom plastic has a seal at the bottom. Just once you remove it, you can see the seal, you remove it. You can notice that the plastic is bending like this with age, I guess. So I'm not sure if that sealing really, really good there. So you just want to replace that seal at the bottom, but also maybe either get a new cover, which is not bent like this, or just make sure the water is really sealed inside, because this this is the air from outside, might have humidity, and humidity might accumulate at the bottom here and might drip inside the footwell. And also, this is the bottom cover of the blower. It has four or five screws. Make sure all all the screws are properly well in place. Usually there's a rear one somewhere that's really very hard to remove and to put back, and people may want to skip that screw when putting back everything together. So if there's a screw missing or a tab broken, you absolutely surely you'll have water dripping from the bottom here, because it has a drain tube, but it just water gets into there like directly from outside. It's really a place where water accumulates right away. By the way, just being there, just check your drain here. You may remove it. You may remove it from the floor and make sure it's clean, clean of debris, and just press it back properly. Today, I removed a carpet, footwell carpet front. This is driver side US model, and that's the passenger one. Basically, the carpet, it's only kept by the seat rails, by those bolts, which are 14 millimeters, are not really tight. The covers that catch over the bolts are just kept in place with the tab. This one, it's not exactly easy to remove. I would suggest not using your fingers, because you can strip your nails and just wound yourself. Just pry with the something metallic, but it needs quite a bit of force. Now mine is broken, but at the beginning is not exactly easy, so maybe not pull with your fingers, right? So what you need for the front carpets, sorry, with the lamp, you need to undo these bolts, this one, and there's another one, the other side of the seat. Remove them, start with the front ones, and then once removed, there is a pin in there, both sides, and this makes it kind of hard to lift, but it's doable. And once you remove the bolts, just pull upwards the rails on both sides, and this will lift the seat for about 2 inches. And then you will be able to pull the carpet from under the rails, pull it away. As for the sides, I don't think I had any clamping points for the carpet. It's just the carpet is just slight underneath each trim all around, with the exception of the hood. Hood release, the carpet is still just sits underneath this trim, but because the carpet, it's like a hole in the carpet which goes there, and it's pretty hard to slide out of that trim, but it's doable again, not too hard. So this is the mine. It's a driver's side, but passenger side is exactly the same thing. So just
remove these bolts on the front of the seat only, lift the seat, pull it with some force, lift it up, and then you can slide off the carpet from under the seat, and then you just pull it down from all the trims around. That's the front of the car. So the main idea I have to the reason I have to remove this carpet, of course, you know, Volvos have several issues with water getting inside the footwells through either the roof drains or I will put a link in the bottom probably with a description. So once the water gets in there, you have a thick foam under the carpet. The carpet will stay very, very dry, but the foam will be really wet with water, and in the long term you will get a nasty smell. And that water, because the carpet actually it's pretty waterproof, so once the water gets under the carpet, it won't evaporate from there, it will stay wet. So the only way to deal with this is really to remove the carpet. Bad news, let's start with a good one. If you have one side which is wet, it not necessarily means the other side, the passenger one, will be wet. But if you have either the driver's side or the passenger side wet, let's say you have the driver's side wet, you see this is kind of like a channel inside. This guy goes straight to the rear footwell. So there is no doubt, if you have the front well on either side wet with water, the water will go by this place and you will have absolutely the rear or the under the seat carpet, both will be wet too. So we'll have to remove all the carpets on the side when you have a front footwell wet. So this is bad news, but that's how it is. Now, like I said, I'm at the rear of the car because the front well on this side, mine was on the passenger side, the front one was wet. I checked the carpet under the seat, and this is the rear carpet, and it's wet here too. That's because the water got in the back. So now I have no choice but to remove the rear carpet completely. So again, to remove the seat cushion, the bottom cushion, you may check the other videos. There's just a clip here how it works. You have both sides a clip. There's another one there. You just don't move anything, just grab the front of the cushion seat and give it a kick quickly upwards, and it should pop up. Do the same the other side. And that's all it takes to remove the cushion, right? There, I noticed there's a clip in there. Just from the trim, just slide it like this, carefully. This will free this clip. Same on the other side. And now to the seat bolt, the seat rail bolt. Again, this is not easy. I'm not sure why it's so hard, but you just try not to put your fingers in there. Not sure I can get this with the camera in my hand. As you can notice, it's really hard. Yeah. Anyway, you try by yourself. And this will expose the two rear bolts, which needs to be removed in order to pull the carpet from there. There, and the metal here, that's where it's touched. By all means, do not pull it with your fingers. It's not only really hard to pull, but you will definitely scrap your fingers. So, the way I'm doing this, just grab a hammer like that, reach where the tab is, grab it with the hammer, and then pull it. Give it a good kick. Mine is already slightly broken. That's why it went so easy, but it's really hard to remove. But this point I have all the four bolts. This is the driver's seat, so all four 40 millimeter bolts have been removed, both front and rear. I didn't disconnect anything in the seat. I suggest disconnecting the battery because there's a lot of SRS wires under the seat. Carefully those, but take your chance, take a chance. So I really just actually bend, push the side, the seat like this on the side, and by the same time I did slide the carpet. Show you. This was the hardest part. This is the door, front door. I had to slide the carpet from under this trim, so it's the hardest part because you have not much place. But once that done, the carpet is really just push it under each trim, so you just pull it on it. And this is the whole carpet. This is just the left side of the car. Now I'm gonna do the same thing on the right side. Center armrest and stuff here is just really slide. The carpet just slide in underneath, so there's no attach or anything. So now I'm going to do same thing on the right side of the car. So again, let me show you. Try to pay attention to those wires, how they are fit before removing the carpet. Those are the SRS. Part of them are the SRS system for the seat belt. Really important, make sure don't disconnect anything. Protect those wire, and when you pull the carpet, make sure you don't grab any wire, so you are keeping safeties. So as you can see, this is the rear carpet, underneath the carpet, the bottom of it. This is behind driver's side, this is behind passenger, front passenger side, and that's in the front passenger side that I got the water getting. So you can see the rear right passenger side was wet as well, completely wet compared to the other side. So you have no choice. If you have water in front footwell, the corresponding rear footwell would be really wet as well.